Hey everyone, and welcome to another week of Mullet Over. Today, we talk about one of the less popular but still powerful decks in the current meta, Facehunter. After it gained traction in MT Montreal, a handful of GMs like Blitzchung and even control expert Yarla began to include Facehunter in their lineups. The archetype now has a pretty impressive overall win rate of 54.3% in GM, even getting banned in three different series last weekend. Because the deck has such a low curve, you can make a case for keeping nearly any card in the right situation. Except the secrets, of course, because you'd rather pull them out with Facestalker, which is just about always kept in the mulligan. But the abundance of 1-drops in the deck makes it tricky to optimize your mulligan, and it's highly matchup dependent. For example, Dwarven Sharpshooter is a solid keep when you expect your opponent to get on board early, so Alan keeps it against Tempo Mage. However, when he faces Druid, he throws it away in search of a higher damage output card. Facehunter mulligans are also synergy dependent. Two of the 1-drops in particular, Tour Guide and Intrepid Initiate, are only powerful turn 1 plays if they can be followed up by particular cards. You can still settle for keeping Initiate off coin as a guaranteed turn 1 play, like Just Saiyan does, but as soon as he picks up Tour Guide to lead into his Facestalker turn, he delays the Initiate game plan. The only 1-drop you should almost never keep is Vulpertinger, because ideally you'd rather tutor it out with Scavenger's Ingenuity to double up on the buffs. The 3-3s are an absolute beating in just about any matchup. In fact, when facing Priest, Druid, and Bomb Warrior, you should prioritize both of the delayed payoff cards, Scavenger's Ingenuity and Imprisoned Felmal. While they don't immediately impact the board when played, the stats you get when they're active tends to be more than what the opponent's removal can handle at the time. For the same reason, early Imprisoned Felmaw is your best shot against Facehunter's poor matchup of Soul Demon Hunter. The 4 health statline is resistant to both Soul Shear and Shard Shatter Mystic, and so it can be highly problematic to remove, as Frozen demonstrates. Against a slower matchup, you can even keep Lorekeeper Polkelt, or with a super light hand, you can keep Voracious Reader. But in both cases, you just need to make sure all your mana is spoken for in the early turns. Those early decisions are often close and crucial. Take Blitzchung's turn 2 versus Tempo Mage. In this spot, he can either play Adorable Infestation and Tour Guide to kill off Chansu's lab partner, or go with Scavenger's Ingenuity. With the farmer line, he'd eliminate the chances of a good cram session or arcane breath for the mage, but if the turn 3 scavengers lands a 50-50 on Facestalker, he'd be unable to play it until turn 4. In the end, he goes with scavengers on 2 because whether he gets Vulpertinger or Facestalker, his turn 3 is a huge power spike given that the tour guide is saved in hand. Speaking of Tour Guide, a common question is how to value the zero-cost hero power when you don't necessarily have Facestalker or Dragonbane in hand. The hero power is your least efficient source of damage, but in longer games, you need to weave it in across several turns to get more total damage as the game goes on. In this turn from Just Saiyan, the difference maker is the Voracious Reader he has on board. With 3 more cards drawn before his next play, he can almost certainly spend all his mana on more efficient damage sources than the hero power, so it's better to save it in case of a Dragonbane draw. However, without the reader, you'd likely begin pressing the button every turn in this type of spot. It's much easier to optimize hero power usage post Lorekeeper Polkelt, since you can plan out your damage allocation in advance with a curated deck order. That's why it's a close call for Blitzchung to forego Lorekeeper Polkelt on curve against Druid, which would give him a guaranteed Dragonbane plus Tour Guide combo for turn 5. But he chooses to develop 2 secrets instead, one of which is likely Freezing Trap, to play around Bank Yugi's best response of Innervate plus Guardian Animals. This exact combination of Freezing Trap and Pressure Plate would neutralize both beasts in the case of GA and preserve Blitzchung's minions, which nets him more damage in the long run. And by the time Blitzchung does get down the Dragonbane, it has a clear path to Bank Yugi's face for lethal. Thanks for tuning in to this episode of Mullet Over. Catch you next week with a deck from the final stage of Round Robin for Grandmasters Season 2.